Hallelujah. Good and blessed afternoon to all the people na hindi po natin nabati kanina. Good and blessed afternoon. And to all the people who are joining us online, good and blessed afternoon. Can I invite each and everyone to stand up and let us pray to the Lord? Hallelujah. Tayong lahat po ay manalangin. Let us pray. Our most gracious Lord and Heavenly Father, the one whom promised us that He has a plan for us, O Lord. And thank you for that promise, Father. We acknowledge according to your words, according to the words that are reminded to us through our dear sister Lorna, that you, our God, has a plans for us. Plans to prosper us and not to harm us. Plans to give us a hope and a wonderful future through Christ. Lord, maraming salamat sa hapong ito. Thank you so much for the wonderful privilege, opportunity na you have gathered us in your house once again this afternoon. Lord, thank you for everything that you have shown, everything that you have allowed us to experience and encounter thus far. Father God, we continue as we continue in our service, even as we continue in hearing, in studying about your words. Lord, we pray by faith that may your words dwell richly upon us. That may your words, O God, have an implication, have a purpose upon us, O Lord. As for your servant, O God, Lord, I pray, I commit my heart unto you, I commit my mind unto you, I commit my spirit unto you. Lord, let it be, cause it, that none of these words, Father God, are as an outcome of whatever it is that is in my heart. That it won't be an outcome of whatever it is that it is in my mind. But Father, let it, Father God, that these words are coming from your words, O God, that we can reference them in your words, Lord. So Lord, thank you so much. You give the spirit of quickening and understanding upon these very words that we are about to receive from you this afternoon. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Thank you very much. Sige po. Tayong lahat ay maupo. Oy, sorry Chris, you are there. Eventually, you will learn the language. Both Chris in there and Chris in there. Eventually, you will learn the language and you will end up speaking better Tagalog than us. Alright? Hallelujah. Okay, if you have your Bibles, let us please open them in the book of Matthew, chapter 19, verses 16 to 26. Hallelujah. And I know we heard about this passage before. And it is my prayer na maging memorable itong mensahe ng Panginoong ito. Because I don't think that we have ever heard the message. We have ever heard about the passage taught to us this way. Amen. Before, when we read about these passages, we take it literally and hindi natin naiintindihan kung ano yung gusto niyang sabihin. And it is my prayer this afternoon that through the grace and glory and mercy of the Lord na maintindihan po natin ang ibig sabihin ng mga mensaheng ito. The word of the Lord, it says in there, "Now a man came up to Jesus and asked, 'Teacher, what good thing must I do to get eternal life?' 'Why do you ask me about what is good?' Jesus replied. 'There is only one who is good. If you want to enter life, obey the commandments.' 'Which ones?' the man inquired. Jesus replied, Do not murder. Do not commit adultery. Do not steal. Do not give false testimony. Honor your father and mother. And love your neighbors as yourselves. The man replied, "All these things I have kept. What do I still lack?" Jesus answered, "If you want to be perfect, go sell your possessions and give it to the poor. And you will have treasures in heaven. Then come, follow me." When the young man heard, he went away, being sad because he had great wealth. Then Jesus said to his disciples, "I tell you the truth. It is hard for a rich man to enter the kingdom of heaven. Again, I tell you, it is easier for a camel to go through the eye of a needle than for a rich man to enter the kingdom of God." When the disciples heard this, they were greatly astonished and asked, "Who then can be saved?" Then Jesus looked at them and said, "With man, this is impossible, but with God, all things are possible." Amen, church? Wow, it's a very powerful story. Amen. It is a very powerful story. And we were just after praise and worship, where our sister Marianne held back in encouraging us about the love of God. She did not held back in encouraging us about God can strengthen us. She did not held back in encouraging us that God is full of compassion, that God is full of mercy and grace. Amen, church? At this afternoon, no? It says in here in 2 Timothy chapter 4, verses 1 to 8. Diba? Our God, my dear brothers and sisters, is a complete God. Inasmuch as you and me, every one of us, we have a different facet. Amen. And it says in this passage, 2 Timothy chapter 4, verses 1 to 8, "In the presence of God and of Christ Jesus, who will judge the living and the dead, and in the view of His appearing in His kingdom, I gave you this charge. Preach the word. Be prepared in season and out of season. You correct, rebuke, and encourage with great patience and careful instruction. For the time will come when men will not put up with sound doctrine. Instead, to suit their own desires, they will gather around them a great number of teachers to say what their itching ears want to hear. They will turn their ears away from the truth and turn aside to myths. But you keep your head in all situations, endure hardship, do the work of an evangelist, discharge all the duties of your ministry, for I am already being poured out like a drink offering, and the time has come for my departure. I have fought the good fight. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. Now there is in store for the crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will award on that day. And not only to me, but also to all who have longed for His appearing." So what Apostle Paul is saying in here, my dear brothers and sisters, to Timothy, and concomitantly, hindi lamang po kay Timothy, sa ating lahat, amen, sa ating lahat na When we treat the Word of God, it is very good to treat the Word of God, by the way, like Sister Mary Ann encourages us. But my dear brothers and sisters, God is a God full of love. But in the other side as well, God is a righteous judge. Amen. Alam niyo po yung coin? 1 pound coin, but it has two sides. You have the head, you have the tail. They are of both a one part of the same 1 pound coin. When we treat God, hindi naman pwedeng itrato lang natin ang Panginoon dun sa kanyang aspeto, being a merciful and gracious and loving God. Dapat itreat din natin ang Panginoon being the righteous judge. Being ang Panginoon na lahat ng ating gagawin at ginagawa, there is a reward or penalty on it. Amen, church? Yun po yung sinabi ni Apostle Paul kay Timothy. That in handling the Word of God, we must have to balance it. Hindi lamang kung ano yung gusto nating pakinggan at pag-aralan. And in the same passage, my dear brothers and sisters, kung pupunta po tayo one chapter before that, 2 Timothy chapter 3, verses 16 to 17, sabi niyang ganyan, all scriptures, lahat daw po ng salita ng Panginoon na ito, they are breathed by God. Amen. Lahat ng isinulat ng iba't ibang tao na ito na naging Biblia natin, they were inspiration by God. They were breathed by God. And sabi niya rito, mga kapatid, itong mga salitang ito, they are useful for us. Importante sila sa atin for teaching, for rebuking, for correcting, and training in righteousness. Ano po yung purpose na ibinigay itong mga scripture na ito? So that the servant of God, that is you and me and all of us, will be thoroughly equipped for the good works. Amen, church. The purpose of this scripture, mga kapatid, is ihanda tayo to prepare us sa Panginoon. And para ihanda tayo sa Panginoon, ibinibigay ang mga salitang ito na sometimes, mga kapatid, depending on our situation, itong mensahe ng Panginoon na ito ay darating to teach us, tuturuan tayo. Darating ang mga salitang ito para i-rebuke tayo kung mali naman ang ating ginagawa. Para i-correct tayo kung hindi naman tama ang ating iginagawa. Para i-train tayo. Amen, mga kapatid. Yun po yung nasusulat doon. Amen? Hindi po sa akin ito nang gagaling. Binabasa ko lamang po kung ano yung nakasulat doon. Amen po, mga kapatid. So kung ikaw isa kang karpintero at gusto mong gumawa ng bahay, hindi mo naman pwedeng sabihin na, ay, karpintero ako, I don't enjoy na magbungkal ng lupa. Dahil mahirap, ang gusto ko lang ikabit yung mga poste, yung mga joists, yung lahat-lahat para maging bahay yan. Papaano maging matibay yan? Baka ayaw tirhan yan. Kasi pag dumating yung unos, anong mangyayari? Babagsak. Dahil walang pundasyon. So being a carpintero, you have to be aware na importante yung pagbubungkal, importante yung pagmamasa ng simento, lahat anuman yung pwedeng kailangang gawin importante upang yung bahay na pinapatayo natin maging matibay. Ganun din yung pananampalataya natin kay Kristo. Yung pananampalataya natin kay Kristo, when we are building our faith in the Lord, importante po itong lahat ng ito na salita ng Panginoon. Hindi lamang yung God is love tayo palagi. Amen, church. Importante din itong mga bagay na to na yung sinabi niya na pag gumagawa tayo ng hindi tama, dapat baguhin natin. Importante din po yun. Amen, church. So my dear brothers and sisters, sabi niya rito, and I will remind us again of that passage that we read, 2 Timothy 3, verse 17. So that the servant of God, that is you and me, will be complete, will be equipped for the good works. Para ihanda daw po tayo. Diba para sa atin naman pala yung purpose na yun? Amen, church? Even the word of God comes to us as a rebuke. Even the word of God comes to us as a correction. Even the work of God comes to us in a form of teaching or training. Para sa atin din naman pala. Ikabubuti din naman pala natin. Para sa kapakanan pa rin naman natin pala. Kaya nga, my dear brothers and sisters, in this word of the Lord na ating pag-aaralan ngayong gabi, ngayong hapon, pagbubulay-bulayan, wala po tayong ibang motibo rito. Wala po tayong ibang motibo rito. It's the word of God. Ibigay po natin and let the word of God complete the message. Wala po itong ibang pinanggagalingan kung hindi ang salita ng Panginoon. Kaya, I know, we started late, we are already late. I know that when it comes to time, walang taong happy with regards to being late. Amen. But if it is not too much, kung hindi po sobra, mga kapatid, hayaan nyo na pahiramin nyo ako ng oras nyo ngayong hapong ito. Pahiramin natin ang Panginoon, ang oras natin sa panahong ito, upang sa ganun ay maibuhos ng Panginoon ang kanyang salita sa amin, sa atin. Amen, church? Sabi ng rich man, "Teacher, what good thing must I do to get eternal life?" Yun po yung tanong nung rich man. Amen, church? Are we there on that passage? "Teacher, what must I do to gain eternal life?" Sino ka man, kapatid, babae, lalaki, sino ka man, kapatid, mayaman ka man o mahirap, I'm sure yun din yung nasa puso mo. Yan din ang gusto mong makamtan. "Teacher, ano po yung pwede kong gawin upang ako ay ma-save?" Di ba yun yung sinasabi nung taong yun? Amen, church? Jesus, Panginoon, nakakaalam ng sikreto, ano po ang pwede kong gawin upang ako ay magkaroon ng buhay na walang hanggan? Yun naman po yung kanyang hinihingi. Diba yung tanong is, how can I be saved? Who can be saved, mga kapatid? Diba? And ano yung sabi ng Panginoon? Ang sabi ng Panginoon ay, bakit mo ako tinatanong? Diba malinaw naman na nakasulat sa kasulatan kung ano ang mabuting gawin na kailangan mong gawin? Wow, sana all, sabi nung tao, nagagawa ko na pong lahat yan. Tick boxes na lahat yung commandment na yan. Ano pa ang pwede kong gawin? Ano yung sabi ng Panginoon? If you want to be perfect, go and sell your possession and give it to the poor, and you will have treasures in heaven. Amen? Pero hindi po nagtatapos dun. Eh, sabi ng Panginoon, then come and follow me. I believe that even this man sold everything out of charity and ibinigay niya sa tao, pero hindi niya finalo si Christ. Do you think masisave pa rin siya? It is in the following of Christ that one is saved, my dear brothers and sisters. Everything that we do, the commandment that we do, selling our possession and giving it to the poor, those are all good works. Those are all good works. And alam natin, mga kapatid, that Ephesians chapter 2, verse 8 and 9 says that our good works won't and cannot save us. Amen? What can save us is the grace through faith. And how can one say that I have faith without following God? Without following Jesus Christ? Amen? So the key in there, mga kapatid, ang sikreto doon is following Christ. Amen, church? What do we call the people who follow Christ? Anyone? What do we call the people who follow Christ? Christians. But before they were called Christian in Antioch, what are they called? What the Bible actually called them? Christian is not the Bible way of calling people who follow Christ to begin with. The term Christian to begin with was a term that is given by the people. Pero ano ang tawag sa mga follower ni Christ before they were called Christian? Ano yung sabi ni Kristo na itawag sa kanila? Go and make disciples. People are called, who follow the Lord, called disciples. Kaya nga ang ibig sabihin ng disciples is follower, the follower of Christ. Kaya nga yung ibig sabihin ng Christian is follower, follower ni Christ. Amen, church? So ito yung sabi ng ating Panginoong Hesukristo dito sa taong ito. Well done! Mabuti ka pa, nagawa mo ng lahat yung commandment. Ngayon, ibenta mo yung lahat ng iyong ari-arian, sabi ng ating Panginoong Hesukristo, and give it to the poor. But that is just the introduction. What do you need to do is to follow me. To become my disciple. Umalis po yung tao. Amen? Ano yung sabi niya doon? Truly I tell you, it is hard for someone who is rich to enter the kingdom of heaven. Again, I tell you, it is easier for a camel to go through the eye of a needle than for someone who is rich to enter the kingdom of God. Our good works cannot save us. Yung kabaitan natin cannot save us. Our services cannot save us. If ever it is, our good works, yung kabaitan natin, our services should be an outcome, should be an evidence of a saved life. Amen. And it's never gonna be the other way around. Maraming tao ang nagsasabi, ay hindi ko na kailangang pumunta dyan. Hindi ko na kailangang magsimba. Hindi ko na kailangang pumunta sa mga gathering na yan kasi mabait naman akong tao, wala naman akong kasalanan. Hindi po tama yun, mga kapatid. Amen. Good works can't and won't save us. Pakinggan natin yung sinabi ni Kristo, mga kapatid, what the Lord says. Hindi po niya sinabi, it did not say that rich people cannot enter the kingdom of God. Di ba, hindi naman yun yung sabi ni Kristo. Christ did not say that rich people cannot enter the kingdom of God. Christ is not against rich. Hindi niya sinabi na pag mayaman ka, imposible sa'yo na makapasok ka sa pintuan ng langit. Ang sabi niya doon, pag mayaman, mahirap kang makapasok, sabi niya doon. So ibig sabihin, my dear brothers and sisters, even if you are rich, you can still enter the kingdom. Amen? Mahirap nga lang. To the fact, sabi niya dito, mahirap na mas madali pa yung kamelyo na pumasok sa butas ng karayom. Amen? Sinabi ba niya na imposible? Kasi kung pagbabasihan natin ito, if we are to base in this word alone, ang pagpasok ba ng kamelyo sa butas ng karayom, posible o hindi? Sipin natin, posible po ba? Hindi. Amen. Maski kumuha tayo dito ng, maski yung mas maliit, ano ba yung may pet, kunin mo yung pet mo dyan na ano, hamster, and ipasok natin sa butas ng karayom. Siguro, abutin na tayo rito ng pagbabalik ni Kristo, hindi pa natin na ipapasok. How much more yung kamelyo? Pero ano yung sabi ng Panginoon? Mas madali. Mas madali daw na ipasok yung kamelyo sa butas ng karayom kaysa sa yung mayaman na makapasok sa kaharian ng langit. So ibig sabihin, mga kapatid, posible. Amen. Ibig sabihin, mga kapatid, ay posible. Amen. Hindi niya sinabi na imposible ang mayaman na masave. Hindi niya sinabing imposible na maipasok ang kamelyo sa butas ng karayom. Mga kapatid, pakinggan natin kung ano ba ang, kung papaano kilala ang mga mayayamang tao during the time of Christ. Sabi niya rito, 1 Timothy chapter 6, verse 17. Command those who are rich in this present world not to be arrogant, nor to put their hope in their wealth, which is so uncertain, but to put their hope in God, who richly provide us with everything for our enjoyment. Command them to do good, be rich in good deeds, and to be generous and willing to share. Amen. Ito po yung sinasabi ng Panginoon, mensahe ng Panginoon para sa mga taong mayayaman during that time. Bakit niya sinasabi ito? Dahil yung style nila, yung ugali nila, kabaliktaran doon. Amen, church? Yung anak mo ba na mabait, nakikinig sa'yo, pangangaralan mo ba, nasasabihin mo sa kanya na bakit hindi ka nakikinig? Hello? Sino ang pangangaralan mo na bakit hindi ka nakikinig? Yung hindi nakikinig. Same thing dito sa salita ng Panginoon. When the Lord said, command those rich people in this present age not to be arrogant because they were arrogant. Not to put their hope in their wealth because they were putting their hope in their wealth. Amen. Ano yung sabi ng Panginoon? Follow me. Amen, church. That's what the Lord said to that rich man. Follow me. So yun po, that's what the Lord is trying to address sa mga rich man during that time. That makes them difficult to enter the kingdom of God dahil wala po yung pusong pagsunod sa Panginoon. In their arrogance, they depend on their own. Sino ba yung mga arrogante? If a person is arrogant, you depend on your own kakayanan. They depend on their own wealth, mga kapatid. Amen. In studying the Word of God, are we familiar when studying the Word of God and the term called Logos and Rhema? Familiar po ba tayo doon, mga kapatid? Logos, when we say Logos in studying the Word of God, ang pag sinabi nating Logos, ang pinag-uusapan natin yung mga nakasulat dito. Amen. When we say Logos, what is written in there? But when we apply Rhema to what is written in there, ano yung mensahe na gusto niyang ibigay? Amen, church? Yun po yung importance ng Logos at saka Rhema in studying the Word of God. In studying, the new commandment come, hindi natin mapag-aaralan ang salita ng Panginoon kung wala yung kapangyarihan, yung enablement ng Holy Spirit. Amen. Kaya nga, when we are reading the Word of God, as we read as it is, that is the Logos. Habang binabasa natin and the Holy Spirit is revealing to us the message, yun po yung sinasabi nating Rhema. Rhema is kung ano yung mensahe nung binabasa mo na binibigay ng Holy Spirit sa'yo. Amen, church? The Old Testament, they have the same way. The Old Testament, they have the Torah. Or even now, the Jewish faith, the Judaic faith, they have the word that they called Torah. Amen, church? They have the word that is called Torah, and they have the word that is called Midrash. Now, what is this Midrash? Midrash is their way of interpreting what is written in the Torah. Amen. So in us, that Midrash is parang yung Rhema. Malinaw po, mga kapatid. Amen. So during that time, when people read the scripture, when people read the Torah, there is a right way of interpreting it. There is a right way of putting a midrash on it, or now we call it Rhema. Ano po, bakit ko sinasabi ito, mga kapatid? Because in tradition, traditionally, people that time, hindi lamang po si Kristo ang gumamit ng salitang mas madali pang pumasok ang kamelyo sa butas ng karayom kaysa sa rich man. Diba, ngayon nga lang, diba, ginagamit natin na mas madaling, ano yung mga ginagamit nating, ano, para kang naghahanap ng karayom sa talahiban. Diba, alam mo yung mga yun, ano yung ibig sabihin nun? What is the midrash about that? Diba? Na mga kapatid, the way of interpreting this word, when Jesus Christ said that it is easier for the camel to enter into the eye of a needle, ano po yung ibig niyang sabihin dito, mga kapatid? No? That eye of a needle is talking about a narrow door. That eye of a needle is talking about makipot na daan. Amen, church? And itong makipot na daan, if we visualize Jerusalem, if we visualize the Old Kingdom, to be honest, if you visualize your house, you have a narrow door. Sino yung mga may gate dito? May mga sasakyang ipinaparada sa Pilipinas. Diba, maalala nyo yung bahay ninyo na may gate? Binubuksan mo para yung sasakyan, pero pag kailangan mong lumabas na hindi mo kailangang dalhin yung sasakyan, meron kang maliit na pintuan na lalabasan. Amen? Nai-imagine natin? In time, in Jerusalem, ganun din po. Jerusalem is composed of many gates depending on what north, south, west and east you are facing, and we know that Jerusalem is the center that time, mga kapatid, that people go in and go out of Jerusalem. They have gates. Amen, church. They have gates. But we know during that time, or we know if we are watching medieval movies, na pagsapit ng gabi, di ba itong mga gate na to isinasara? Amen. In England alone, if you watch King Arthur and all that, di ba paggabi, sinasara doon nila yung mga gate. But there is a small gate na ibinubukas nila just in case for people na naglalakad. Kasi during that time, if you go to Jerusalem with your camel, with your caravan, with your kalesa, dadaan ka sa malaking gate. Pero kung late ka na, ginabi ka na, hindi ka pagbubuksan. Malay naman nila, baka kalaban na aatake. Amen, church? Hindi ka pagbubuksan. But for people, there is a small gate para lang sa mga taong ito. Amen? Naiintindihan ba natin kung ano yung gusto nating ipavisualize dito? Amen, church? Kaya nga pala, ito yung sabi ng ating Panginoong Hesukristo sa Matthew chapter 7, verse 13 to 14 na, enter through the narrow gate. Enter through the narrow gate, for wide is the gate, and broad is the road that leads to destruction. And many enter through it. But small is the gate and narrow the road that leads to life, and only few find it. And again, Jesus said in John chapter 10, verse 9, ako itong narrow gate na to. That's what Jesus said. I am the narrow gate. I am that gate that whoever enters through me will be saved. They will come out and go out, and they will find pasture. Amen, church. Hindi ko kailangang sabihin, help me here. A camel, mga kapatid, who is late in entering the main gate at night, hindi yan pagbubuksan. If you are the owner of that camel, hindi ka pagbubuksan, it's late at night. Diba? Even the virgins that are waiting for the groom to come and the groom arrive in night time, hindi ka pagbubuksan ng gate. Because if they are to open that gate, they expose themselves to security. Diba? Ano naman ang malay-malay nila? Kung yung papasok pala in that middle of the night is, it's an attack. In the same way na pag ikaw yung may camel ka, hindi mo pwedeng iwanan naman sa labas. That is the reason why that there is a wall that serves as a protection covering. Because if we are outside the city wall, who can protect you? The camel can be stolen, the camel can be butchered. Do not forget, in the middle of the desert, people in from Saudi Arabia and all that, in the middle of the desert, di ba, in the desert, there are community. May mga bandits, may mga tulisan din sa disyerto. Amen, church? And if you leave your camel outside, it can be stolen. If you are the owner of the camel, sabi ni Hesukristo, it would be easier for this camel to go through this eye of the needle. It would be easier for this camel to go through this narrow gate. Rather than a rich man to enter the kingdom of God, kung easier, kung possible pala, what does that camel need to do in order to enter into that narrow gate? Help me here. If you visualize the camel and you want that camel to enter into that narrow gate, ano yung kailangang gawin ng camel na yan? That camel must unload its, yung kanyang daladala. Amen, church? Kasi makipot na yung daan eh. Amen? Makipot na yung daan to the point na makipot. So in order for you to bring your camel inside for the place of safety, yung kamelyo na yan, ano yung kailangan mong gawin? Tanggalin mo yung, kaya nga, di ba mga kapatid, camel is the main form of transportation that time. We've seen them in the movies, how much weight the camel can carry if they travel around, di po ba? A family can have their all belonging within the back of the camel. And if you want to bring your camel inside through the narrow gate, ano yung kailangan mong gawin? You need to make sure that yung dala-dala ng camel must be unload. Amen, church? Kailangan mong idiskarga yung kamelyo mo, mga kapatid. If you are that camel, you need to take away your load. You need to na idiskarga mo yung iyong load, mga kapatid. Hebrews 12:1. Ano yung sabi niya doon? If we are that camel, ano yung sabi niya doon? Let us throw off everything. Especially the sin that weighs us down. Especially the sin that entangles us. Rich man, if you are a rich man, or if you want to enter into the kingdom of God, sabi ng Panginoon, papaanong makapasok ang kamelyo na ito doon sa eye of the needle? Dapat ganun din tayo. In order for us to enter into the kingdom of God, take away the load, camel. And ano, what is that load that weighing us down? Everything, especially sin, it says in there. Tell me, mga kapatid, can you stand face to face with God still with your sin in you intact? Ang usapan dito, papaano tayo makapasok sa kalangitan, sa kaharian ng Panginoon? Makakapasok ba tayo doon na ang kasalanan natin intact pa rin sa atin? I don't think so. So we need to take away everything that weighs us, that hinders, especially the sin, mga kapatid. Amen. Matthew chapter 16, ano yung kailangan natin? Ano yung sabi ng Panginoon sa mga disipulo niya? Whoever wants to be my disciple must deny yourselves. Take up your cross and follow me. Denying yourself, meaning mga kapatid, forsaking everything including yourself. Our fleshly desire, our earthly passion. Ano man po yan? To be honest, sabi nga niya rito, relations, family. Diba, yun yung sabi ng Panginoon dito. Ang ibig niyang sabihin mga kapatid is, tanging Panginoon lamang ang maiiwan. Amen. Because ano yung sabi ng Panginoon? If you cannot do this, you are not fit to be my disciple. Romans chapter 8, yung binasa ni Sister Mary Ann nung Friday na Bible study natin. Ano yung, kung maaalala ko yung sabi niya dun, being people na naniniwala sa Panginoon, nananampalataya sa Panginoon. Sabi niya dun, di ba, let us take away the desire, the power of the flesh. And let the desire and the power of the Holy Spirit lead us. Yung isip daw natin, yung mindset natin, tanggalin natin on the mindset of the flesh. Amen. What do we need to do? Camels, in order to go through that narrow gate. Take away everything. What do we do when we take away everything? That is the process of repentance. Diba? Ano po yung repentance? What is that process of repentance? Yan po yung time na lumapit ka sa Panginoon at sinasabi mo na, Panginoon, eto ako. Ito ang aking kasalanan, ito ang aking bigatin, tanggalin mo. Ibinibigay ko sa iyo. Iniaabot ko sa iyo. That is the process of repentance. And on that camel, ano yung kailangan natin gawin? Take away everything that weighs us down, that entangles us. Amen, church? So if you are that camel wanting to enter to that eye of the needle, to that narrow door, remind me, what do you need to do? You take away your load. Amen, church? Sinubukan mo, you tried. And because it's a narrow door, you cannot still enter. Christian, correct me if I'm wrong. Kasya ba na yumukod tayo sa Panginoon, umiyak sa Kanya at humingi ng kapatawaran? Is that enough? Is that enough? Basing sa Bible, hindi eh. Diba? Kasi sabi ng Panginoon, when the Lord asked the disciples, go into all the world and preach the good news to all the creations. Whoever believes will be baptized. Hindi po humihinto dun. Ang sabi ng Panginoon, teach them to obey everything. Amen. Camel, you're trying to enter that narrow gate. Tinanggal mo na yung load mo, tinanggal mo na yung mga dala-dala mo, yung mga bigat mo, and you found out na hindi ka pa rin pwedeng makapasok. Because it's a narrow gate, and you are a camel, what do you need to do? What do you need to do, my dear brothers and sisters? Imagine that, visualize that. What do you need to do? Imagine that camel na trying na pumasok. Ano yung kailangan niyang gawin? That camel will. Nakita niyo yung leeg ng camel? Can you see the neck of the camel? And if you want to enter that narrow gate, what would the camel will do? He will try initially to put his head inside. Amen, church? He will initially to put his head inside. That camel will bow down his head. That camel will stoop down his head. And that camel find out na hindi pa rin siya makapasok. Do you know that camel, they do not only walk like that, they can also walk in their knees. Diba? Mga taga Saudi, alam nila yan eh. Nakikita nila yan. Camel does not only walk like that, the camel can kneel down on all its all four limbs and walk in their knees. Camel, that is the only way to enter to that eye of the needle. Tinanggal mo na yung load mo, tinanggal mo na yung weight mo, and you found out that you cannot enter. The next thing Jesus says is, you bow down your neck, you bow down your head, you stoop down, you kneel down and walking on your knees. What does that mean? What is the message in there, mga kapatid? What does that symbolizes to us as a Christian, buhay ng isang Kristiyano? If one person bow down and stoop down and one person walk on their knees, hindi lamang po kasya na lumuhod tayo sa Panginoon, umiyak, hihingi ang ating kapatawaran sa pagiging Kristiyano, mga kapatid. We must walk in obedience. We must walk in submission. That is the next step after repentance. Di po ba? That is the next step after repentance. After repentance, after kang nagrepent sa Panginoon, what next comes next is your obedience and submission. Matthew 28:19-20, sabi ng Panginoon, go and make followers of mine from all the nations. Go and make disciples from all the nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. After that, ano yung sabi niya doon? Teach them to obey everything that I have commanded you. And surely, I will be with you to the very end of age. Pakinggan po natin mga kapatid, no, napaka-importante ito sa lakarin natin bilang isang Kristiyano. This is a very important in our walk as a Christian, because up until we will not learn, hanggat hindi natin matututunan ito, yung virtue ng ating pagiging Kristiyano will always remain to the fact na I profess my faith to the Lord. I hiningi ko ang kapatawaran sa Panginoon. I hiniling ko sa Panginoon yung Romans 10:9. But up until we will learn, mga kapatid, to obey and submit, hindi po tayo lalago. Believe me. Even this church, hindi lalago. Not only this church and every churches, hindi tayo lalago kung hindi natin matututunan yung obedience and submission. Hindi tayo magmamature. What is obedience? Help me. Lahat tayo magagaling. Ano po yung obedience? What does obedience means? Obedience, my dear brothers and sisters, is a passive process. Obedience is a passive process. Wala, Sister Michelle, wala yung mga fee show dito? Oh, Sister Michelle, fee show ka, di ba? Ikaw? Wala, Sister Michelle, wala, Sister Joanna, saan yung mga fee show dito? Or mga nurses, alam natin yan. Di ba? When moving the joint, di ba mga kapatid, pag ginami mong ganyan, if you move it on your own, that is an active movement. Amen. Move my limb, Gab. When someone move it for you, that is passive. Amen. So when you say passive, maski ayaw mo, someone is moving it for you, that is passive. Alright. Mangmingiti na si Ate Abilina, naalala niya na yung anatomy niya. Ate Abilina is Ate Abilina, dineclare mo nung isang araw na ano, binigyan mo na ba ng ano yun, certification? Now, let's go back. Obedience, my dear brothers and sisters, is a passive process. Obedience ay hindi lamang paggusto natin. Obedience ay hindi lamang pagwilling tayo. No. Obedience, my dear brothers and sisters, even if you go and study your dictionary, study everything, obedience is a passive process. Obedience is hindi lamang pagwilling tayo. No. Obedience, hindi po magiging obedience yan, mga kapatid. No? Obedience is a passive process. Maski ayaw natin, that is obedience. Maski hindi tayo willing, that is obedience. Saan po natin ito ini-a-apply, mga kapatid? Saan po natin ini-a-apply itong obedience na ito? What is submission in the other way? Ano po yung submission on the other hand? That although sometimes obedience and submission, they are usually used together, or sometimes they are interchangeable with one another. They are closely similar. Pero ano po pag sinabi nating obedience? I mean pag submission. Obedience is you do it willingly or unwillingly, but when you say submission, it is the attitude of the heart. Amen. When you say submission, it is the attitude of the heart. It is the readiness that is coming from your heart to do what must be done. Amen, church. Because coming from the heart ay may kaakibat na pagmamahal. Amen, church. If you are doing what you are doing Because there is love in it, that is submission. If you are obeying maski wala yung kalooban mo, if you are doing what you are doing maski wala yung puso mo doon, maski wala yung pagmamahal sa puso mo doon, that is obedience. Amen. Luke chapter 22 verse 42. Father, Jesus said, if you are willing, take this cup from me. Yet not my will but yours be done. Amen. Jesus said, Ama, ayoko ito. Pero dahil anak mo ako at ama kita, kung ano yung kalooban mo, masusunod. Amen, church. Ephesians 2 verse 8, and although Jesus was found in the appearance of a man, he humbled himself by becoming obedient to death, even death on the cross. Pag sinabi sa'yo, magpapako ka sa cross, gagawin mo. Jesus was in a form of a man. And he was asked by the Father. He was given by the Father for this purpose. But what did Jesus said? Lord, this is not my will. Lord, this is not my will. But because this is your will, because this is your will being my Father, let your will be done. Amen, church. Romans chapter 13, verse 1 to 2. Ano yung sabi niya rito, mga kapatid? Let every one of you be subjected to the governing authorities. For there is no authority except that which God has established. The authorities that exist has been established by God. Consequently, whoever rebels against the authority is rebelling against God, what has put in place. And those who do so will bring judgment on themselves. Tinuturuan tayo. Ipinakita ng ating Panginoon kung papaano ang mag-obey, kung papaano ang mag-submit sa kanyang Ama. Bilang anak, hindi yun yung gusto niyang mangyari. This, as being a human, Lord, this is not my will, Father. But because this is your will be done. Amen, church. And this is the reason why that God, according to the pattern of His Son Jesus, tinuturuan tayo. Let everyone, with the exemption of no one, be subject to the governing authorities. For there is no authority except that which God has established. Malinaw. Amen. There is no authority except that which God has established. The authorities that exist has been established by God. Consequently, whoever rebel against the authorities, rebelling against what God has instituted. Amen. Ano yung pakiusap ng ating Panginoon? 1 Peter chapter 2 verse 13. Submit yourself for the Lord's sake, for every human authority. Yun yung pakiusap ng Panginoon sa atin. All of us, submit yourself for the Lord's sake, sa kapakanan ng ating Panginoon, to every human authority. Ephesians chapter 6 verse 5,
Obey your earthly master with respect and fear and with sincerity of heart, just as you obey Christ.
Ay, wala siyang karapatan na ma-obey, wala siyang karapatan na marespeto. But Jesus said, 1 Peter 2:18, be subject to the governing authority with all respect, not only to the good one and gentle one, but also to the unjust, also to the cruel. Mga kapatid, these are the word of God. There is no point kung yung lahat ng naririnig na pag-aaralan natin the last 7-8 years, hindi niya binabago ang ating buhay. Hindi natin na i-apply sa ating buhay. And in this world, hindi lang minsan, not only now, I already mentioned this few times in the past, that in this world, there are three authorities that the Lord has instituted. There are three authorities that the Lord has instituted. Mga kapatid, government, give to Caesar what is due to Caesar. Amen. Government. Number two, mga kapatid, family. The family that the Lord put us into. Mga bata, kung saan kayo ipinanganak. And number three, spiritually. Those are the three that the Lord instituted. Government, mga kapatid. Kaya nga sabi natin, obedience is passive. Because the government says, pay your taxes. Maski ayaw mo, you have to pay your taxes. Because that is obedience. Yun yung dinidemand ng government. When the government says it is against the law to steal a car, maski gustong-gusto mo nang nakawin yung sasakyang nakikita mo, bawal mong nakawin. Amen, church? Dahil pag ninakaw mo pa rin, ano ang kahihinatnan mo? Amen? Children, we were once child. Now it's your turn. You are placed under the care of your parents. Father and a mother, your loving dad and a doting mom. You must have to honor their authority because God has placed them as authority above and over your head. You must honor their covering. Amen, church? That is part of the commandment of the Lord. Honor your father and your mother, and that is the only commandment that comes with the promise. Amen. And what is the promise that comes with it? You will have a long life. If you want to have a long and prosperous life, obey your parents. Amen, church. And even in the church, bakit natin iwasan ang church? Diba? You know, in the Philippines, ito mga kapatid, we are all adults. We are all mature people. Ano po? Na pwede naman tayong mag-usap according to the word of God. Kristiyano tayo. And as being adult, mga kapatid, do you know how many excelling sports people are leaving the Philippines? Marami, di po ba? We have a grandmaster in chess that left the Philippines and are now representing other country in a sporting event. We have a fencer who is now representing Ivory Coast this coming Olympics instead of Philippines. Because why? Bakit po? Because they do not appreciate how the Philippines is dealing on their training in all that stuff. Can you stop them? Can you blame them? Help me here. Can you stop them? Can you blame them? If you are in their shoes, what is the most decent thing to do? Follow their footstep. Amen. Because if you said that you, I blame them, what are you doing here? You study nurse, you study engineer, you study whatever degree. Why are you in other country? Because Philippines cannot give you work. Why, if the Philippines can give you work with the same salary that you're receiving in here, do you still like to go out of the Philippines? I doubt. Amen. Does it make sense? So even in our government, these people, if you feel that the government was supposed to provide you is not providing you whatever it is that you need, that's what we have done. Children, many families are broken. Many families are broken. As a parents, you gave birth to a child. You provided for them. You give them everything that you can give. And sometimes it's a success story. But there are those stories where, why is it that the social services take away children from families, especially here in the Western culture? Why is it? Because they are not being provided for what is supposed to be provided for them. Covering, shelter, clothing, safety, security. If any of those elements is breached, the government take them away. We are all in the healthcare. We know, we saw that happening. Amen, church. Amen. Or how many times that, di ba, nakita natin yung katrabaho na yan, o yung kakilala na yan, na yung kanilang mga anak, walang respeto sa kanilang mga magulang, and when they turn 18, the parents show them the door. Reality or not? Even in the church, mga kapatid, hindi lang sa sure. We all came from Catholic faith. We all came from Catholic faith. Sino ang hindi galing ng Katoliko dito in the prime time? Sina Sister Grace? Saan church kayo galing, Sister Grace? Ha? Evangelical. Saan po kayo galing na Methodist? How do you call yung leader nyo sa Methodist? Pastor or pastor? Pastor din. Even if you go to Catholic, even if you go to Baptist, even if you go to anumang church denomination, there is someone in the front that is called by God to be there. And whether you are Catholic, you must have to honor and respect the priest. Because if you are serious about your faith, dyan ka ipinagkatiwala ng Panginoon eh. Dyan ka ipinagkatiwala ng Panginoon. Masama siyang tao, hindi ko gusto yung ano niya. Dyan ka ipinagkatiwala ng Panginoon, kapatid. Again, this is for everybody. This is for everybody. This is po para sa ating lahat. This is the word of God. This is the word of God. And I myself, if we go to a place, Papa, if you apply to a work, if you go to a workplace, nag-apply ka ng trabaho, hindi mo gusto yung environment ng work, hindi mo gusto yung yung pamamalakad sa work, hindi mo gusto yung manager sa work, what is the decent thing to do? What is the decent thing to do? Sorry? Resign. Find another job. Find another work. It's the decent thing to do. Mga kapatid, these are the words, work of the Lord. You know, in the church, we are not here to grow membership. We are not here to grow membership. Dahil maski sino ang susunod na patatayuin natin dito, maski si Brother Ramon, si Brother Alan, Sister Grace, Sister Annie, Sister Michelle, maski sino ang susunod na patatayuin natin dito, they will rely on you, mga kapatid. They will rely on you. Magre-rely po sila sa inyo. According to the word of God, kung ano po yung kailangan nating gawin. That camel, mga kapatid, first, took everything. Took the baggages away. That camel tried to stoop down. That camel tried to walk in its knees. Hindi pa pala kasha. It's not enough. Because what will happen to the camel, mga kapatid, as it passed through in there, it's the narrow gate. It's the eye of the needle. What will happen to that camel? Magagasgasan siya. Di ba? Magagasgasan siya. Because he is going to try to force itself dito sa makipot na pintuan na ito. It will be harmed. It will be wounded. It cannot stop in the middle. Otherwise, he will be stuck. So the camel will continue. Wound being inflicted, one wound on top of the other, and so forth, up until makarating siya sa kabila, at the other side of the wall, because at the end of the day, people of God, Christian, di ba yun po yung gusto nating mangyari? How can we get to the other side? How can we get to the kingdom of God? And sometimes it's not enough to unload the weight. It's not enough to obey and submit. In the process, we will be scored. Alam mo yung patatas na ipadaan mo yung peeler? We will be scored. And we continue. And we continue, and we continue. So 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 21. It says in here, this is why you were called. Because Christ suffered for you, leaving you an example that you should follow in His footsteps. Camels, you tried and you find out that you're stuck in the middle, continue until you get to the other side of the wall, until you get to that desired na gusto niyong marating. Romans 8:36, as it written, and Psalms 44:22, for your sake, O God, we face death all day long. For your sake, O God, we are considered as a sheep to be slaughtered. No? Kasi mga kapatid, as a camel, as a people, yun yung tinanong natin sa Panginoon, Lord, I want to get to the other side. I want to get to the kingdom of God. What do I need to do? The camel, the Lord said that it is easier for that camel to pass through to that eye of the needle. And it was demonstrated to us this afternoon how to get through to that eye of the needle. Mga kapatid, everything that we are doing ngayon, here, everything that I'm doing here is how to get through to the other side. Lahat po ng ginagawa natin dito ngayon, whether we come to church to sing, whether we come to church to serve, we come to church to sit down and listen, all of this, mga kapatid, wala po tayong common interest. But how to get to the other side? That's the reason why that camels, men and women of God, we thought that going to that wide gate is the right way because that is the comfortable way. If you go to that wide gate, wow, that is the comfortable way. You can get to the other side without experiencing what the camel experienced, for you to be surprised that you get to the other side and it is not the side that you were hoping, you were wanting to go, because Jesus said, those wide gate leads to doom, failure, and destructions. Let us enter into the narrow door. Let us enter Jesus as being our narrow door. Amen, church. So again, this is the word of God. And the word of God is sometimes it's good to hear the word of God that, brother, sister, God bless you. God loves you. Come to the Lord. But mga kapatid, we are maturing in faith. In this year, church alone, we are 8 years old. Maski saan man po tayo pumunta, maski bumalik tayo sa Katoliko, kailangan pa rin natin itong mga bagay na ating narinig. The Church of the Lord, hindi po tayo nagpaparami ng miyembro. The Church of the Lord says, disciples. We are making disciples for the Lord. We are not increasing the church membership. And maski, sabi ko nga, maski kayo po yung tumayo rito, maski kayo yung isunod nating patayuin dito, maski sino po yung isunod nating patayuin dito, kailangan nating suportahan. That's what fellowship means. Amos, sabi niya doon, how can two walk together if they cannot agree? Hindi naman po sikreto kung ano yung ginagawa natin dito para sa Panginoon.
So mga kapatid, let the word of God dwell and reach with us. Mga bata, especially that you are growing in the Lord. Sa mga matatanda, and lalong-lalo na to all the leaders. Sige, ibalik po natin ang papuri sa Panginoon. Hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus. Tayo po ay tumayo. Hallelujah. I just want to read that song na kinanta natin kanina. And sabi nga ni Sister Mary Ann, let it be our prayer, let it be our lament and cry to the Lord. The message of the song says, I come to you with my heart in pieces. And when I do that, I found the God with healing in His hands. We want to receive healing from the Lord. Sometimes we need to be broken. I turn to you and put everything behind me and found the God who makes all things new. The Christian life is a newness of life, mga kapatid. And when we decide to enter the Christian life, in order to receive that newness of life, we need to make sure that we would have put everything behind. I look to you, drowning in my questions, and I found the God who holds all wisdom. Mga kapatid, kung meron tayong tanong, kung meron tayong hindi naiintindihan, it says in there, if we want to find God's wisdom, we come to the source of wisdom. We come to God. I trusted you and I stepped on the ocean. You caught my hand among the waves. Was si Apostle Peter. That was Apostle Peter to desire to walk above his circumstances. Walk above his faith. Walk above his situation. But by doing that, my dear brothers and sisters, when he was, nung naistorbo siya, he began to sink. But what happened? He put his trust in the Lord. If you put your trust in the Lord will not only allow you to walk over and above your situation, but sometimes when the discouragement of life comes, we begin to sink. But if you trust in the Lord, even if you sink, the Lord can draw you out. Cause you're the God of all my days. Each step I take, you make a way. and I will give you all my praise. Ba? Because you are the God of all my days, not only on Sundays, but also in Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. That means that each step I take, whether I am in the midst of the believer, or whether I am at work, or whether I am walking in the community, it is you who make each and every, you make a way for each and every step I make. And because of that, I will give you all my praise. My seasons may change. My situation may change. My circumstances may change. But the Lord is constant. The Lord stays the same. So my dear brothers and sisters, let us come to the Lord. Napakaganda nung mensahe nung kanta. I would wanna go on and continue to read and be inspired and inspire you as well sa mga mensaheng ito. But I pray that the Holy Spirit will complete the message sa ating lahat. I understand. I appreciate it. Naiintindihan ko, mga kapatid, people who are online. Naiintindihan ko that because of delivering these words, that some of us are not happy, some of us are not pleased. Naiintindihan ko, mga kapatid, na we are not happy, but it is not up for me. This is not the intention, this is not the purpose. And I pray na kung ano man yung saan ako nagkulang, to let us understand. I pray na kung saan man ako nagkulang, na ipaintindi sa atin ang salita ng Panginoon. I pray na kung ano man yung mga pagkukulang at pagmamalabis. I pray na kung hindi ma yung hindi nyo naintindihan, na hindi ko na i-explain ng maigi. I pray na instead na mapagaan ko yung inyong kalooban, ay mas lalo kong napabigat. I pray na kung ano man yung hindi ko nagawa, may the Holy Spirit fulfill His message upon the life of each and everyone. I pray, Church, that the Holy Spirit reveal to us His heartbeat. I understand. I appreciate. And let us both come, seek, and pursue the Lord. And let the Lord reveal His ways, His plans, and His desire to you, to the person standing next to you, to everyone in this room, and to the people online, as well as yung mga wala rito na mga kasamahan natin. Father, here are your words, O God. Lord, I pray that if in any way, in any shape and form and capacity, O God, your servant bleat out these messages without considering your words, without the true interest of your people at heart, then Lord, I am here saying, I deal with me, and even so severely, O God. But Father, if these words are yours, I have only one desire, O God. Let these words change the heart, the mind, and the personhood of each and everyone in this room. Your servant, most importantly, the people who were joining with us online, and to all the people who will come across this message at a later time. Father, let your will be done. Let your will be done. Continue, Father God, to teach us your words. Continue, Lord, to open our hearts for receptivity. Continue to open our mind. Continue to open our spirit, O God, that, Lord, encourage us to look at your other facets, to look at your love, most importantly, to look at your grace and mercy, most importantly, to look at the strength, the miracle, the provision, and all the good things that you can do for us, more importantly. But Father, may we never neglect to look at your holiness as well. May we never neglect, Lord, to look at your holiness, O God. Because your word says, without holiness, no one can please God. Father, reveal your power right now. We desire for your presence right now. Pour out your presence upon this church right now. Prepare the heart of your people right now. Prepare brothers and sisters, leaders, O God, ministry members, Lord, everyone, Lord. Father, thank you for your words. Thank you for your words, O God. It may have come to us as a rebuke. Even your servant has been utterly rebuked. It may have come to us as a learning, as a teaching, as a training in for righteousness. But Lord, may your purposes, your will, may be served, O God, so that the man of God, my brother, my sister, and everyone in here will be prepared for the good works that you have prepared for them. Father God, maraming salamat sa iyo, Lord. Lord, I pray by faith, Father God, that You seal this message. You seal this message. You seal this word, O God. Just like the life of that woman, Lord, that we have heard, that we have read, who broke that expensive alabaster jar perfume and poured it at your feet. Father, you have said that wherever the word of the Lord is preached, that Father God, in memory and in legacy of this woman, her acts of faith will always be told. Her acts of faith will always be shared. Father, it is my prayer, Father God, that each and everyone in this room and each and every people online, each and every people that will hear about this message today, that Father God, it is quite a different approach, especially with the word that says that a camel pala will be able to pass through that eye of the needle. Father, I pray that whenever these scriptures, Father God, will be shared, will be mentioned, Lord, remember your people. Father, personally, remember your servant, O God. At Father God, sana, when we remember this day, hindi namin maalala whatever state of feeling that we have, but Lord, sana ang maalala namin ay kung ano yung idudulot niyan sa aming buhay, Panginoon. Maraming salamat. And again, Lord, ibinabalik ko sa iyo ang iyong mga salita. Holy Spirit, complete your words. Complete your message. Complete your will upon the life of each and everyone. Father, thank you that you have given us this wonderful opportunity and privilege to come here, O God, to pursue you, to seek you, to experience you. Lord, sa aming paghihiwalay-hiwalay, we pray by faith, most importantly, na ikaw, O Lord God, ang siyang kasama namin. Lumakad ka, Lord. Be our comfort. Be our strength. Be our guide. Be our lead. Be our teacher, Panginoon. Lord, kung meron kaming hindi naintindihan, kung meron kaming hindi nagustuhan, Lord, ibalik namin ito sa iyo, Panginoon. Ibalik namin sa iyo, Panginoon, and we pray na ikaw, Lord, ang siyang magbukas, Father God. Maraming salamat. And Father God, we pray that the peace of God and the comfort, mercies, and grace that transcend all understanding will guard our hearts and our mind through Christ Jesus our Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen.
Tayo at pasalamatan natin ng bawat isa that sabihin natin that we are blessed na nandirito tayo. And sabihin natin sa ating kapwa, kaya nga ng salita ng Panginoon, na kung ano yung ginawa mo sa iyong kapwa, para mo na din ginawa sa akin. So, sabihin natin na mahal natin yung mga kapatid natin, puntahan natin, i-hug natin, yakapin natin, or i-shake hands natin. Amen? Amen.
Oh, I love you with the love of the Lord. Yes, I love you with the love of the Lord. I can see in you the glory of my King.